Assalamu alaikum. My question has to do with darura, the necessity. There are Muslim businessmen who have Muslim restaurants that say it's halal. Everything in the restaurant, in their business, may indeed be halal, all the products, but they financed the expansion of their business on riba, on interest. And they have a second, a third, a fourth store, it becomes a chain. The food is halal, the workers are paid well, but this question is in my mind.
Okay, so I will let also Dr. Nadawi answer. I alluded earlier to the concept of halal and tayyib. We said there is halal food, but also the kasb. How do you earn it? How do you earn it? And the methodology. Now, as far as you eating in that restaurant is fine, you're eating halal food because the food is halal, the person doesn't sell nothing that's haram, no cross contamination. Now what do we do? Is the person who has no other ways to finance, that's a separate topic. As far as the food is concerned, it's halal. He's responsible for whatever transaction. That really leads us to talk about financing. If you don't have no sources of financing, what do you do? I leave that question to Dr. Nadawi to answer. But as far as the food is concerned, if you eat it, it is halal. As a matter of fact, all the halal food that you buy, slaughtering houses, they have line of credits, they have they borrow from banks. I don't know any business that does not borrow from banks. So if you want to go that route, then you will starve and die. So all these large providers of halal meat, I am 100% sure that they are borrowing money from the bank. So like Sheikh said in his speech, we need to see how we can benefit from the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Things were not wholesale and legislated. We have to build towards the economy. Halal 100% you're not going to get. Even in Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam predicted that even those who will stay away from riba, they will be touched by its dust. Ghubarwa. So, there is no perfect world, but it is intention in Islam. Remember what I always say, Allah never judges by results, He judges by intention and effort. Do we have the right intention? Are we making the effort or just, you know, expecting others? As far as if you want to address the financing issue for businesses, who are struggling to establish themselves, I will give the mic to you.
Yeah, you know, our Fuqaha, when they established that our necessities, necessity of life, actually three categories. One, we call it darura of essential, right? We will die if we don't use it. This darura means halal nafs, that I will kill myself, I will die if I don't, for example, have this thing. So suppose water or the oxygen and kind of these things are darura. The second level is hajiyat, which is making my life easier. Otherwise it will be a little bit difficult. The third one is tahsiniyat. Tahsin means decorative, make a little bit luxurious. Little bit luxurious, not luxurious, but a good, yeah, good life. So our Fuqaha is saying that darura is giving us a permission to use something which is restricted in haram, but we can use to save life. But first important thing is, what is the definition of darura? It is very important. Otherwise, everything we can say is my darura, it is your darura, and so on. So darura always means the fear of death. And if it is not 100% that, but it means, exactly, if I don't do this, then I will die. Just like suppose some medicine is going to save life, and this medicine contains something bad. They say it is the rule. But our Fuqaha, they made some eczema of it. One thing is, al-darura tuqaddaru biqadariha. When you have a necessity, so it's supposed to be limited according to the need. And if I need, suppose, for example, $15, right, so I will not go with $20 and so on. If I need just like one home, I will not go to buy two home and three home. So darura tuqaddaru biqadariha. Second maxim is al-dararu yuzal. We have to do something to remove the darura. It's not supposed to be That's not by heaven. And meantime, you know, darura now I become any, that's like, you know, no problem to talk about it or think about it and so on. So in that sense, actually what the point you are talking in Islamic finance, one thing you must understand according to philosophy of halal and haram, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks us to provide something, He gives us replacement. And if He says to me, don't eat pork, and He stopped here, right? It would not be solution. So He said, eat lamb, eat cow, eat this and this. So solution is there, right? So when I say riba is haram, right? So what is the alternate? Right? Alternate is there. But the problem is that to bring alternate need joint effort. It is not one person's effort. Whole community is supposed to be mobilized to bring alternate. So in that sense, if we say that in our time, and this is right to say that in our time, 100% is not available. So we judge according to the major part of our ability. Right? But we encourage our community, and I think this will be a good, you know, I can say the result of this conference, that those who have an ability to go some, seek some kind of alternate, they think how we bring Islamic system to replace the river. Right? In this way, for example, the need will be removed, and it will be limited, and it will not go there forever.
It's other one that go too much into Islamic financing. We had a conference before, we will address it again. Our situation in Canada and around the world, there's no real Islamic financing. There are attempts here and there, even in the Muslim world. And nobody would invest in each other. So the reality is there is no 100%, but you have to do your best. Same thing for housing, which is a necessity, not need, not only haji, it's daruri. But again, darura, alhamdulillah, Allah Azza wa Jal understands better, but we shouldn't abuse those exits. And as Sheikh said, if you have to do business, you have no job, what are you going to do? And this is, you know, how all you know how to cook. Nobody wants to invest in you. They don't know you. Where are you coming from? You just showed up yesterday. Why would they give you money? Unfortunately, we have a lot of stories in our community. If your money is borrowed, you never come back. This is a personal story. All the money I have given, most of it never came back. And you have to spend more money chasing them to get your money back. So personally, it would be very hard for me if I have money to lend someone. Because we don't have that level of trust. And when you give it, you do intention even for your own relatives. You just say, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Expect it to be set up. So we live in a society that is very hard to get the financing. Brother, you have a question about the food?
Yes.